ask you. We ask you. To accompany us in order to show your word to the people. If that will hear your word, you will hear him. And if someone receive you, you shall receive him. And if this man has problems, you are going to solve his problems. In the name of Jesus, we ask you to bless the listeners in the name of Jesus. Amen. We want to show you the topic of our message. God hates magic. And in this picture, you shall see a man that is another kind of man. He does not come from this earth. This man comes from another world. And it comes from the war that took place in heaven. And God has precipitated the demons on earth. And when they were in heaven with God, they knows what God does not like. But when God precipitated them on earth, when they came among the people, they want to push the people to disobey God and go to hell with them. So when they came on earth, they shall enter the people in order to show them how to practice magic and eat idols. How a man that is born can know how to practice magic. If you do this or that, and that can become a magic. Only the demons show this to the people. And the demon shall come with dreams. And the dream shall be hard for the people. And the demon shall go, and she will enter another person that practice divination. And when the people has dreamed hardships, and she goes to the diviner. If he goes to the diviner, the demon shall possess the mouth of the diviner. And she shall say to the man, your dream, it is the demons that is in the mountains or in the trees or in the waters. It is these demons that wants you to come and give them a chicken. As your dream is a very hard dream, you are going to obey. And if you go to the mountain and do what he asks you to do, in the waters, you become enemy of God. And as you have accepted them, you become the same with them. You become the same. You live, but you are the possession of the demon. And this demon has become your God. So Jesus has come. And if you have already obeyed their words, and if you have made divination, or practicing magic, or worshipping the idols, you shall confess it. In the name of Jesus, the tail that he has in his hand, the tail is the symbol of the pact. And the diviners and the witch use the tails to make magic. And the demon shall show. You are going to look for a chicken. And you are going to talk to the tail. And you shall sacrifice the chicken. And the demon shall drink the blood of the chicken before obeying what you ask him. If you want,
that the demon goes and binds somebody. You are going to talk to the tail and sacrifice the chicken. And the demon shall hear, and she shall go in order to chain up the man, and nobody shall see the chain. But if the man is chained up, the man cannot do anything else. Some people, they are bound, and if they are sat, they are like that, and those cannot travel any longer, and those cannot succeed in their business. And if they are making commerce, nothing is wrong for them. The demon has chained them up. And if they have taken a man and give him to the idol, the demon of the idol shall bind the man, and he cannot do what he wants to do. And when Jesus came, if you are in this situation, and if you confess it, and if you repent, and if you want to stay with Jesus, Jesus shall break the chain of the devil, and he shall save you, and you shall become a man of God. That is the purpose of the coming of Jesus. We are going to enter the message. Our first message in Isaiah 47, verse 8 to 15. And we are going to read Isaiah chapter 47, verse 8 to 15. We are going to read, you that do what you want to do. You are in hardships in your heart, saying, it is I alone, nobody else. I shall never be a widow, and nobody shall take my children. And even if you are making divination a lot, and if your magic is powerful, so these two things they shall happen to you in the same time. And the loss of your loss of children and the loss of your husbands, they shall meet. And you shall get loose. And you have hardened your heart in the wickedness. You say, nobody sees. And your intelligence and your science have put you away from the ways of God. And you think in your heart, it is us alone, nobody else, and something evil shall happen to you, and there will not be a solution, and you shall get hardships, and you cannot stop it, and destruction shall come upon you, and you cannot prevent it. So stand firm in your divination and your magic. In your divination, you that are suffered from them till your childhood. So these things can be benefit to you. Sometimes you shall be heroes. You are so many advices, but they suffer you. So now, let them save you. It is people that know things that come from heaven, and that know things that come from the stars. And in dark moon, they show you how things shall happen. Look, you shall be like fire that is fired. They cannot save themselves from the fire. This is not a fire that man shall harm himself with. And this shall be for those diviners, you that have suffered yourself, going unto them since your childhood. All those shall be spread away. Where we have read, the Bible says, all those who practice divination, and these are demons of divination and magic, if he speaks, and if you obey,
If you accept,
you shall become a possession of this demon. And this demon shall become your God. And God says, if this demon speaks, and if you hear, if this demon speaks, and if you accept what he says, and if you go and do what he asks you to do, God has prepared fire. Nobody that cannot stand before and harm himself. You that has listened to the demon and that has obeyed the demon, you shall accompany the demon and you shall go together to hell. God has prepared this thing for diviners, for the worshipper of idols, for the high praise of idols. They are in the angel of God. And God says us, if since your childhood, you shall give you only that you confess it in the name of Jesus. And Jesus shall forgive you. If you do not give your idols to be burned, and your idols to be burned, God has prepared a fire, and it is you and your idols that shall enter. But if you burn first the idols, and if you obey Jesus, you shall never burn. This is the light of this picture. We are going to move forward in Ezekiel, verse 13, 17. And this shall help us. Ezekiel 13, verse 17. And there the Bible says,
La massa,
now,
Michel Bia,
man of God,
just for never parvenir.
Look at your wife that is speaking to themselves. And they say that they have no knowledge. Give them my voice, my words. And tell them that I am the Lord. And I say,
Hey,
women that are practicing magic and with their hands and their tie clothes in order to destroy the other people, you shall get hardships because you are destroying the souls of my people and you let your soul save. You go to my people asking for millet and meal. And you are flattering my people that like liars. And you make insult that those who do not die, die. And those who must die, live. So, the Lord God says,
yes.
Look, I hate the works of your hands. You use your hands in order to destroy the people. I am going to break your hands. And those people you want to destroy, they shall be saved. And you shall know that I am the Lord. And I shall break your tie cloths. And I shall save my people from your hands, and you shall never overcome them. And you shall know that I am the Lord. Where we have read, God says, in the past time, there were women in my churches. And what did these women do? They are practicing magic with tie claws.
Man team.
And they are practicing magic with their hands. As they are obeyed what the demon says, the spirit of the demon accompany them. And if somebody goes to them to pray for them, when they are going to pray, the demon is here. And if they speak, and if the man wants to believe, when they are going to pray, the spirit of the magic enter the man.
So when the people are leaving, when the demon of magic enter his life, he shall die. He is not a man of God no longer. And this happened in the churches. And God says to Ezekiel, do you see what the women are doing in my church? My people like liars. And the demon of magic is a demon of liar. And they use the women to destroy my people. Look, when the women are speaking with the power of their magic or the power of the divination, if my men believe, when he is believing, the demon enter him and his soul die. But my people do not know. The magic destroy, kill people. And you have not to accept any words. If you make divination, if the diviner speaks with the mouth of the demon, when you are believing what the demon, what the diviner says, the spirit of divination enter your life. And you are living, but you are dead. And the Bible says, do not listen to the diviner. If you listen, you shall die. We are going to move forward. Ezekiel chapter 14 verse 1. The elders of the people of Israel came unto me, and as they are with me, the Lord God has said to me, man of God, those people like worshipping idols. They are looking for what has pushed them to make the sin, And I shall let them ask me, so, speak to them that I am the Lord, and I say, any Israelite that like worshipping idols and that is looking what he has committed as sin and came to the prophet, it is I myself that is going to answer him. Because of the number of his idols, The idols push the people to be so far from me that I myself shall answer the people and they shall fear me. God says, Ezekiel, some people are bound with the demons. They are bound with magic and divination. But as they are bound, they are in the hand of the demon. And they are in my house. When my word goes out of my mouth, they are listening to it. And they want to obey. And if I say to them to have love and patience and love each other and making a sincerity, if they hear, they say, what I have heard, I shall obey. I shall never do like that. And when they enter the house of God, not being delivered from the demon and the idols, they are in the hand of the devils. They are not free. The devil says to them, being in my hands and obeying the word of God, that cannot be possible. And if you go, today I'm going to get patience, and the demon push you to fall down.
You shall never, never, never obey God. And that is the word of God. The demon of magic pushed the people to fall down in fornication, in stealing, in liars, in jealousy. And that is the demons of the magic that are doing these things. So you have to confess it and repent. And you are going to throw the idols. And God shall help you. If not, you cannot listen to God and obey. Even if you want to obey, you cannot. Because the demon himself pushed you down. And the people do not commit the sins by their own will. It is because they are chained up by the demon. And the demon push them in order to make them drunkards. And some are killing themselves. And some are hating the people. And that is the work of the demons. We are going to move forward. Acts chapter 19. The book of Acts chapter 19, verse 13 to 20. Some magician that has Jews tried to cast out demons by the name of Jesus. And they say, I say to you, in the name of Jesus. Paul is preaching. I command you to go out. And those people that are doing like that,
Shiva,
that is one of the sons of the chief priest, the one of the seven sons of the chief priest. And the demon answered them, I know Jesus. I know Paul. I know who is Paul, but you, who are you? The possessed man stood and he picked them and disputed with them and overcame them, and they fled from out the house naked and hurt. Not any diviner, any magician can cast out demons. If you are not delivered from this demon, you cannot cast out a demon. This demon said, we are going to cast out demons. And the demon said to them, we know Jesus. We know Paul. But who are you? The demon. They do not know diviners. They know the man of God. If you became a man of Jesus Christ, the demons knows you. But if you are still in the magic, and the demons sees you as nothing, all those who have the weapons of the demons, as the world is going to an end, all the weapons of the demons are destroyed. Everything that can be good is destroyed. And only what can be evil and worse exists. And so is the world, the present time in which we are. It is a chief priest. He was following God. And the sons of this chief priest are fall down becoming magicians. Today, there are chief priests that are pastors. Even their own children are committing adultery and fornication. And even those children, their children are drunkards. In the past times, It was magic that the sons of the high priest was committed. But now, it is adultery and drinking alcohol that the sons of the pastors are committing.
Do you see?
We are going to move forward in Numbers
23:20.
And this shall help us. Numbers 23:20 to 24. The Bible says,
look,
they say to me, to bless. Because they are blessed. I cannot change his word. They did not see a sin in the sons of Jacob. They have not seen hard things, hardships in Israel. The Lord God is with them. And they are preaching his name, saying, you are the king. And God has left them from Egypt. And they are look like the power of Baphomet. For them, not any magic can overcome the sons of Jacob. Divination cannot overcome the people of Israel. What we are saying, in the past time, Balaam, he was among the people of Israel. And Balaam was called. We know that if you curse, the man is cursed. But we ask you, we want that you come and curse the people of God. In those times, the people of God was following God in due time, righteously. They are not seen. If they commit the sin, they repent of the sin and God forgives them. Balaam came. He looked at the people. And he knew that there's not sin in the people of Israel. And Balaam said, the people you see, I do not know anything that the magic can destroy them. I do not know any place that idols or divination can enter and destroy. Because God is with them. Do you see? If you let these demons, and if you are in the presence of God, Balaam said, magic cannot destroy you. Divination cannot destroy you. If you try, you shall see that it is like that. So receive Jesus. And you shall be in rest. And the diviner shall fall down. And the diviner shall die. Because they shall try to destroy you. And they think that you are sleeping. That your God does not sleep. Your God does not sleep. The God that protects you, he is more than the keeper of the world. Do you see? We are going to move forward. In Jeremiah 17, verse 5 to 9. There the Bible says, the Lord says, those people that have abandoned me and rely on men and rely in power of men, they shall suffer. They are look like abyss that has in the desert. There are no joy. They are in a salt place that are in a desert. And the people that believe in me and rely on them, he is in peace, in joy, and he is look like a tree that is round, that is round the water, and his roots are in the depth of the water, and he do not suffer about warm. And he its leaves are always fresh. And if the desert come, he does not afraid. And he shall bear fruits. Here the Bible says that we know
that to God,
verse 8,
that if anybody rely on a man with his power, this man must know that he is in suffering. No man has peace, no man has joy in order to help his neighbor. Nobody has courage and peace in order to help his neighbor. Why? Because he's a man. Those who give power and peace, God does not give a man the power to get peace and courage to help another man. You shall rely on your father, and this can be a very hard situation with you, and that can be hardship to you. You shall rely on your own mother. If God does not put peace in this, you shall become in war with your own mother, and you shall not want to see each other. You shall rely on your senior brother and your brother, and you became enemies. And God says, rely on me, God. If you rely on me, you are look like a tree planted around the waters, and its truth is in the depth of the water. Even if there are not rain, as it is beside the water, its leaves are fresh. And God says, rely on me, God. This one that has created you, he wants that you rely on him and be confident in him, and he shall help you. Do you see? We are going to move forward.
Now, Ezekiel
11:17. Ezekiel 11:17. And this message shall help us. 11:17. There the Bible says, say to them that I am the Lord, and I shall gather them out of the nations, all the nations they were scattered in, and I shall give them back the land of Israel. And if they went there, they are going to mix out everything that is evil, everything that I hate, and I shall give him a new heart and a new knowledge, and I shall change their heart that is like a stone in the heart of man, and they shall obey my commandments and my laws, and they shall be my people, and I shall be their God. Where we have read, there was a time, and the people of God say that following God is too difficult. The custom, the religion of other people is easy. If you are there, you drink alcohol, you commit fornication, you commit adultery like you want. So they went. They went in order to be with those who worship idols. And when they went, they gathered with them. The demons of idols have changed their hearts, and they cannot obey God. So, when they were with the demons, those who were with the demons started to die. And God has had pity for those who had not died yet, in order to put them out. And when they put them out, God says, your heart has already changed. You are not men at all. You have become demons. And as I am making you out, if you go to the land I give you, the first thing, You have to put your idols, your magics, your magic charms, and burn them. And you shall throw them. Second, you shall confess, I have done this in order to adore the magic charms, and I repent in the name of
Jesus.
I have done this in order to get the magic, but I repent in the name of Jesus. I have done this a divination, but I repent. God said that if you do like that, after that, God himself can, and he shall enter your heart, and he shall transform your heart, and you shall become a man of God. After that, if you listen to his word, you can obey. But if you do not do like that, you cannot obey God. That is what God says. That means that if you obey this man, if these demons are 100 people that are in the church, if these people are not delivered in order that the demons go out of them, and if you teach them with their demons, you are going to lose your time. Nobody can become believer. And you do not work for God. You are working for the demons. And you are advising demons. And all your whole work is a loss. Do you see? We are going to move forward in Psalm 115, verse 3. Psalm 115, verse 3. God is in heaven, and he does what he wants to do with anyone he wants. All the idols that people are worshipping like God, as gold, silver, and that are things that has made by the hand of men, and they have authority, they have mouth that they cannot speak, they have eyes that they cannot see, they are ears that they cannot hear, they are noses that they cannot feel, there are hands that they cannot touch, there are feet that they cannot walk, and no voice came out of their throat. All those who are doing this, they shall be like them. It is the people that rely on them. The Bible says the demons that descended on earth, each that obey, that accept the teaching of the demon, and accept them to practice magic and idols, the Bible says, this man that practice magic, he shall be like the magic. This one that worship idols, he shall be like the idols. This one that obey the word of the demon, he shall be like the demon. And this one that obey the God of truth, he shall be like God. So you have not to obey any word. So if you are practicing magic or worshipping idols, and if you stop whistling, and if you are going to leave the world, you shall become like this God you were worshipping. You shall become like the demon. Do you see? So many people are in this situation. You have not died yet. You are listening to the word. So we ask you to obey in order to move for this situation. The last message is Isaiah 33, verse 1. So the Bible says, You that are destroying the other people. And you are not destroyed yet. And you that are betraying the other people. And you are not betrayed yet. You shall get sufferings. After having destroyed the people, you shall be destroyed. And if you are finished betraying the people, you shall be betrayed. Here the Bible says, God says, you that are worshipping the demons and obeying his word and practicing idols and practicing divination, when you are finished, you shall be like the demon. So we ask you to run in order to repent. If the demon takes you and you steal the people and you kill the people, when you are finished, you shall become like the demon. That is what the Bible says. But if you are still working, even if the people says evil things to you, God does not reward what you are doing yet. But when you are going to
sleep,
now I am tired of stealing. I am tired of killing people. I am tired of practicing magic. I am tired of worshipping idols. Now I am going to rest. So, the reward, the consequences of the reward, do you see? But if you know and you run in order to repent of your sins, Jesus shall bury your burdens. All your sins shall be bared by Jesus. And Jesus shall die at your place. This is a good luck. This is a privilege God gives you to do.
Bishop.
So I ask you to obey. We are going to stop here. And we are going to pray for you. The topic of our message is God hates magic. And this one is a magician demon. We are going to pray. Everlasting Lord, We put your word, and we have given your word to the people. So many people are listening to this word, and they are in this situation, and they did not know that their hand shall be in hell, that today they have known, and they want to make a decision. So we ask you to help them, and we ask you to give them the power to give up the idols and receive you. We ask you to help them in the name of Jesus, and we ask you to have pity for them in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.